Flight Mechanics 3, which is the basic description of aircraft axis system. So here I've got an old wind tunnel model of an aircraft. So just like a real aircraft, a wind tunnel model has to have a definition of an axis system. So we define the axis system for this in exactly the same way as we would for an aircraft. So traditionally, the x-axis will be along the longitudinal axis of the airplane, basically parallel to the fuselage axis. The y-axis will be out in the starboard wing direction. Okay. Now the z-axis will be orthogonal to the xy plane in the right-hand vector sense, so the x-axis will be vertically downwards for this case. X forwards, right, y along the starboard wing, and z vertically downwards. Okay, so the origin of the axis system will be at some convenient location along the aircraft. Now an aircraft, most aircraft have got a symmetry axis about the vertical plane, so the origin of the axis system would be in the symmetry plane of the aircraft at some convenient position along the aircraft. The center of mass position can change, so the coordinate system will just be located somewhere convenient on the aircraft. And also remember that the fuselage has got height, so we have to think about the vertical position of the axis system as well. And then what we need to consider for developing flight mechanics models of aircraft are the positions of the other major important features along the aircraft. Any control surfaces, like the canards, the tailplane, the wings, where are they, position of the cockpit, position of anything along the aircraft will be positioned relative to the origin of the coordinate system on the aircraft. Okay.